Welcome to the video on retinoblastoma. In this video, we'll be discussing what retinoblastoma is, the diagnosis criteria, the underlying genetic cause, the mechanism of disorder, and treatment options currently available. But before we begin, we'd like to note that this video content is intended for informational and educational purposes only and does not provide a diagnosis. Individuals who experience similar signs and symptoms are advised to seek professional help. So let's get started. What is retinoblastoma? Retinoblastoma is a rare type of eye cancer that occurs most often in children under the age of 5. It accounts for approximately 2% of all cancers that occur in children aged 0 to 14 years of age. Retinoblastoma begins in the part of the eye known as the retina. The retina is a thin layer of tissue that lines the back of the eye and is made up of nerve tissues, which sends light and sense signals through the optic nerve to the brain to be interpreted as images, thus enabling vision. This cancer can affect either one eye, known as unilateral retinoblastoma, or can affect both eyes, known as bilateral retinoblastoma. The initial detection of retinoblastoma usually begins when parents realize there is something wrong with their child's eyes. Some common signs that parents may notice are leucochoria, which is a white glare in the pupil, strabismus, which is eyes looking in different directions, heterochromia, which is different colored irises, eye redness, eye swelling and inflammation, blurred vision and squinting, and even pain in the eyes. When it comes to diagnosing retinoblastoma, it is important to note that retinoblastoma can be divided into two categories, the first being intraocular retinoblastoma and the second being extraocular retinoblastoma. Intraocular retinoblastoma can be divided into five groups, groups A to E, based on how likely the eye can be saved and refers to cancer being contained within the eye. On the other hand, extraocular retinoblastoma is divided into four stages, stages 1 to 4, based on the spread of the cancer, and refers to the cancer spreading outside of the eye to distant parts of the body. Some tests and procedures commonly used to diagnose retinoblastoma include eye exams, ultrasounds, and magnetic resonance imaging. These procedures are conducted by ophthalmologists, also known as eye specialists. Eye exam is where the specialist checks eye health and also looks for signs of retinoblastoma, some of which include glaucoma, which is increased eye pressure, proptosis, which is enlarged eyeball, and may also explore other eye conditions, such as lazy eye. The specialist may also take images of the inside of the eye to determine the shape, size, and location of the tumors. Another procedure includes an eye ultrasound. This method is used to find the location of the tumor in the eye. It is conducted with a wand-like structure that uses sound waves to take images inside the eye. Lastly, an MRI can also be used. MRI uses radio frequency waves to determine the size and number of tumors in the eye. This technique is used to investigate the severity of the spread of cancer from the eye to other parts of the body. So you may be wondering by now what the underlying genetic cause of retinoblastoma is and how it's inherited. So let's get to that right now. Retinoblastoma arises due to mutations in the retinoblastoma gene, commonly abbreviated as RB1 gene. This gene is located on chromosome 13 and encodes for a protein called retinoblastoma protein. This protein plays an important role in controlling the division of cells within the body. Retinoblastoma can be either heritable or non-heritable. In heritable retinoblastoma, the mutated RB1 gene is inherited from either one parent and the mutation is found in all cells of the body. More specifically, in each cell there is one mutated RB1 allele and one normal RB1 allele. Affected individuals could possibly pass the mutation down to offsprings via an autosomal dominant mode of transmission. Despite this inheritance pattern, the patient usually develops the second mutation in the normal allele as well. This is necessary for the development of retinoblastoma. This phenomenon is known as Knudsen's two-hit hypothesis, which states that both mutated alleles of a gene are necessary for the development of cancers like retinoblastoma. On the other hand, in non-heritable retinoblastoma, the individual does not inherit the mutated RB1 gene, but rather the mutations in both alleles of the RB1 gene are acquired over time, and most often acquired before the age of 1. There are some key differences between heritable and non-heritable retinoblastoma. For example, the symptoms experienced by those with heritable retinoblastoma are more extreme and serious when compared to those experienced by patients with non-heritable retinoblastoma. Now that we have an understanding of the underlying cause, let's take a look at the mechanism by which this disorder occurs. So to begin, let's understand the cell cycle and its importance. The cell cycle is a series of events that takes place in a cell to allow it to divide. The cell cycle consists of five phases: a G0 phase, a G1 phase, a G2 phase, an S phase, and an M phase. During the G1 phase, the retinoblastoma protein, commonly abbreviated as PRB, is bound to E2F, a transcription factor. A transcription factor is a protein that helps to regulate DNA transcription. The binding of PRB to E2F prevents E2F from binding to DNA and transcribing genes. The transcription of genes creates proteins that are necessary for DNA replication. When cells reach the G1 checkpoint, which occurs at the end of the G1 phase, they seek entry into the S phase, which is where DNA replication occurs. Prior to entry into S phase, E2F must bind to DNA and transcribe the required genes needed to make proteins for DNA replication. To set E2F free, PRB needs to be inactivated. This is accomplished by phosphorylating PRB. Phosphorylation refers to the addition of phosphate groups to a protein. The phosphorylation of PRB is accomplished by the cyclin D CDK4/6 complex. This complex adds phosphate groups to PRB and sets E2F free from PRB. Thus, in this way, E2F is able to bind to DNA and transcribe the required genes. In this way, the cell's progression through the cell cycle is controlled. However, in the case of retinoblastoma, the mutated RB1 gene leads to the production of an abnormal PRB protein. As a result, PRB is not effectively able to bind to E2F. E2F, in this case, can continuously transcribe the genes needed for DNA replication, and cells continuously move through the cell cycle and rapidly divide. This ultimately leads to the formation of tumors, as seen in retinoblastoma. Finally, let's take a look at some treatment options. Treating retinoblastoma depends on many factors, some of which include the spread and location of the tumor and the stage of the tumor. The ultimate goals are firstly to cure the cancer, as we don't want it to spread, followed by preserving vision as much as possible. For early stage intraocular tumors, local treatments are typically used that interact with the tumor itself. These include cryosurgery, which is freezing and destroying the tumor, thermotherapy and laser therapy, which is heating and destroying the tumor, and radiation therapy, which is placing radioactive material on the eye to treat the tumor. These interventions are often done in conjunction with chemotherapy. As the tumor grows larger and spreads, the tumor may need to be removed by surgically removing the eye itself. This is known as enucleation. Researchers continue to investigate the optimal treatment regime for retinoblastoma through large clinical trials comparing these surgical and pharmaceutical interventions. Following treatment, long-term follow-up is necessary to monitor for potential reoccurrence of cancer. Signs to look out for include new vision problems, headaches, or the presence of lumps or swelling in the area. We hope this video provided you with a greater understanding of retinoblastoma. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more demystifying content.